Hi.
Professional. Dot.
We're playing Factorio.
Hello.
Yay.
Hi.
That voice you hear
Hi.
is either my inner dialogue, which for some reason has an Australian accent, or it's Lolash. We'll leave that for you to decide.
Hi, I'm Blum is in a monologue, and I don't know who Lolash is, but must be a pretty great guy. We're playing Factorio, Llama, and I am kind of, I am confused. Hey, you're making, like, circuit boards and stuff.
Yeah, circuit boards, red science, and bullets down on the end by the steel.
You're making steel? Wow, you've been doing things. What's this fancy blue stuff? Lead. Right. So, we have, is this glass?
Yep. So we have iron and wood and copper and glass and lead and tin and stone and steel. Happening.
Tin and steel.
Oh, Googly Moogly so wants me to start off first thing in the morning with deep thoughts and conversations. Do I want to... Is that a thing I want to respond to right now? Sure.
Yeah, why not?
Let me respond with the caveat that my brain is currently just woken up and may not make the most coherent sentences you've ever heard. But I am given press copies of games sometimes, and I buy games sometimes, and I get games as gifts on Steam from viewers sometimes. The press copies are generally the full game, both an advance, you know, you get it a week or so early to do a review, and it is the full game and you can keep playing it if you desire. So, now, I don't know if I've heard Lolash's rant about why people should play full price for a game and not use gray market sites. And I also don't know how that's related to the question of press copies. Because if a publisher is choosing to give out copies of their game as a marketing cost, I don't feel bad about playing that game at all. Because that's what it's for. And the fact that I didn't pay them for the game is not hurting their bottom line. That's part of their advertising costs of running their business. If that's... I don't know if that's the connection you were trying to make there, but if that's what it is, then I think that if you think of it as their advertising cost that they gave me a game, there's no moral gray area there at all.
Yeah, so I'm the same. I get press copies for games. There are several sort of distribution networks for press copies of games, and those press copies of games are given freely with no strings attached. Like, you're not required to cover content, you don't have to say anything specific about the game, and that's the only way I'll take a press key. Like, I don't do any kind of hey, say good things about our game and we'll pay you money kind of stuff, because that could be morally ambiguous.
And if I ever did, you would know. Mm-hmm. Like, every 3 minutes while I was talking about it, would be, this is a paid promotion for this game. Be very clear. That would be a thing.
But the whole gray market reseller site thing is a whole different kettle of fish. The reason I have ranted about that in the past is because a lot of people have said I should sign up for websites, which I won't name specifics, but certain grey market websites that are known, that like there is no doubt, it is absolutely proven, like empirically, that they do not source their keys from reputable sources. Like, some of the keys that they get come from stolen credit cards and things like that. And by supporting those websites that are in turn supporting effectively criminals that are ruining people's lives, I think that's a bad thing. It's the same reason I don't buy big brand name clothes and stuff, is because a lot of the big brand name clothes are made using things like child labor in Asia. And if I don't know that an item has been, like, I buy Australian made mostly, because in Australia we don't have things like sweatshops, and that's, there's like a whole different like dark political element.
The bottom line content, is,
you know, I don't want to support.
It's wise to just be careful what kind of businesses you're supporting, because you support every part of their activities, and, you know, just be aware of what it is and make informed decisions.
Absolutely. So, Llama, Bob's Mod, I don't know. what is our goal? What are we doing?
My plan is, and maybe this should be my plan for after today instead of for right now. But my plan for the next moment or two is to set up a bunch of warehouses to grab all of this ore that's not being smelted, because we very prematurely mined all this ore, so that we can clear out this whole area and build a train station where all these original ore patches were. That's my plan. Recluse Stellaris is a thing. And if when you say we should have a Patreon night, if you mean my monthly Patron's Choice broadcast, you don't have to worry about getting the patrons to pick Stellaris, because it will get played. 100% for sure.
Just a little bit, maybe.
Yeah.
Teeny tiny.
That game will happen.
Stores many, many items. Warehouses, hey? And storehouses. So you want to basically build warehouses and start putting ore into warehouses.
Which maybe, isn't something for right now. Maybe we should be automating green science and getting some other stuff that's more interesting to do done before you need to go fall asleep. Sweet Mercy's warehouse holds a lot of stuff.
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, so I probably could put some red arms in here and have this warehouse store all of this zinc and all of the copper. But that's the idea, is if we dump all the ore out of the mines into a place where we want it, then we free up the map to do other stuff with.
So do you know what I think? I think if we have a warehouse dedicated to each of the ores, because we're going to be mining them off-site and bringing them back to our primary smelting location, right? That's our intention. So if we have one warehouse dedicated to each ore type, and then we mine all of these existing ore types and put them into their individual warehouses, then we can build a train station, and the train station can unload, and we can sort the ores into their warehouses. We can build a sorting station, so one unloading station can basically just
the train unloads every kind of raw material possible. And smart inserters separate the ore into warehouses in a warehouse area, and then the warehouses feed the smelters.
Yes.
So do I want to put the warehouses not where I put this one then? I guess, like, these things are going to have so much stuff in them that once they are full, we do not want to be moving them.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
we should think about where they get to live. Recluse was talking about a multiplayer game with patrons for Stellaris. Is that a thing?
I mean, that's a thing we could consider doing. I mean, the main concern, and like, please do not take this wrong, all of the patrons and just viewers out there, is it's very difficult to play a game with you. Like, with viewers. Not because you're bad people or anything, but just because... how do you say this, Llama?
Here's how I say it. I don't do multiplayer casts. I do guest appearances from streamers who I know and know their content and trust. Like, by the time I let you play a game with me on my channel, it's because I know who you are. Because I am super paranoid about the content on my channel and, like, a big control freak. And multiplayer terrifies me because I've never met you. And I don't know what you're going to be like. And if I put a patron reward that is multiplayer games, then literally any person can just show up on my stream. And I am too neurotic for that. It absolutely petrifies me. Because I need more control of my content than that. And so, like, maybe a multiplayer game, but no voice chat could get me over my neurosis. Maybe a but even that scares me because of text chat in game, and I don't want to hurt anyone's feelings by brutally beating them at games, which is probably not a thing I should be worried about because I am terrible at video games. But you know, like, every multiplayer game has the chance to spawn bad feelings. And I really want to avoid bad feelings because I like you guys and I want you to like me and I don't want us to have a reason to hate each other.
Llama, I'm feeling like the warehouses should be down here.
If we're feeding these from the top, shouldn't the warehouses be at the top?
We easily reverse where we're feeding these furnaces from. Right.
We did for certain definitions of easily.
it does mean that we can't extend the smelting areas at all, but the belts are able to take so much anyway, right? So we're not gonna be able to have many more smelters than this on a line.
I think
anyway.
If we go up to blue belts, they could potentially be three times this long. I don't know if that's how we want to design our smelting area. You know, the other option is to make it wide rather than long.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, that's a thing where we don't know Bob's well enough to know which things we're going to want lots of, and it's just hard to plan.
And it depends on the scale of the base that we eventually end up having. How many different ore types are there that we've seen / discovered? We've got copper, iron, stone.
Well, there's
coal.
So remember, there's ore, but there's also alloys.
They're the defaults.
And I don't know that. I mean, maybe we could sit down and plan how many alloys we have to also make.
But the alloys. We're just talking raw materials, like metals that are coming out of the ground and being shipped here by train. That's all we need to warehouse.
Okay. The beacons recluse are, if I'm thinking of the right thing, they let you put modules. You could add modules to the beacon, and then any building within range of that beacon will get the module effect.
Googly, you're not getting direct sound from my cast, which is going to throw it off a little bit. Also, I am very tired. Very, very tired. And I am always a computer simulation. I am not a real boy. You should know that already.
All right, so...
So I
just don't know how to plan for the scale. I don't know what the scale is going to be. And maybe we don't do warehouses now.
No, I think the warehouses is a really good idea because we can start churning all of this ore and out of this area. And get rid of this mess of belts and just have warehouses instead. which I really like the idea of. Okay. I'm counting colors. I'm trying to count colors. So there is pink, very light blue, yellow, purple, pink, very light blue, yellow, purple, white, copper, iron, stone, coal. 10, I think, is enough.
10 warehouses? That's all of the... all of the stuff?
I think it's enough. With the caveat that I just made, which is... tired. I think it's 10. How many materials do we have close to us? And what are we lacking?
We don't have silver ore. I think that's the only one that's missing, but I don't know.
If you go to the map, if you open the big map and zoom it all the way out, there is a green ore, and there is a purple ore that I can see on the map.
Oh, yeah.
So that's 2 more.
Because we don't have green or purple by us?
Yeah.
Okay. And we do have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 by us. No. 8 by us.
8 by us.
7 by us. No, 8. 8. Sorry. I was counting the smelting areas, and the steel one doesn't count because that's iron. So we have 8 by us plus those 2, so we need 10. I have 4 warehouses in my inventory. Yeah.
Okay. Warehouses require stone bricks and steel plates. I am going to do some slurping.
Hey, that stupid mod I hate didn't pop up on my screen. Yay! I should stop criticizing it now that it's not bothering me anymore. But it bothered me so much.
Are we out of reds?
We can do like mining drills 1 to buy some time while we're still doing red. But it is... I mean, green is identical to unmodded green, so we should probably just do it.
Yep.
All right, I'm building 2 more warehouses. I will have a total of 6 momentarily.
I am building 2 more warehouses, so that gives us 8. I just need wood, actually, of all things.
How do I have 2 warehouses in my inventory? Wouldn't I be in its inventory instead? You would think that, but we are clearly Time Lords, and everything is bigger on the inside. Everything is bigger on the inside.
Wood. I'm building the last 2 warehouses in my inventory now, so that gives us 10. So we need to here.
Where are we putting them? I kind of want to tuck them in along this shoreline. Up here? Is that too far from the smelting area?
I just thought they'd go in nicely here, and we could have the unloading train station sort of south of here.
I just want to leave us tons of room for the train station, because the chances are it's going to want to run and unload many trains at once.
Well, we have plenty of space to the south. Like, these water patches we can fill in.
Yeah.
And the forest we could remove. And this sort of links in very close to, like, the actual warehouse. Because you want the warehouses to be reasonably close to the ore lines, right? I think. Like, I think the warehouses could go in
What if we put them even closer to the... I mean, the warehouses ultimately are going to supply our big smelting area. What if we put them on this side and just fill in some of this water for where we need them?
Um, Yeah, that could work. I'm going to need to make much more landfill.
Yeah, I sure hope there's a lot of stone on this map, because... landfill.
A big chunk of stone, like, west of us. I don't think we're going to have too much trouble with resources as long as we're willing to make trains. And I am definitely willing to make trains.
There's a thing called a water be gone. Fill bodies with water using landfills from your inventory.
How does one make a water be gone?
We need a blue circuit. Or a basic electron, or a, whatever that board is. Basic electronic board.
Okay. How does one make a basic electronic board?
A fine question.
I ran out of landfill. Well, no, I've still got plenty of landfill in my inventory, I guess.
Why can't... there we go. So do we want to just run our warehouses side by side? I don't know how we want to organize them. Do we just want a big row of 10, and we can load them from the bottom and unload them from the top? And leave no space in between them? I don't know what we want to do with them.
That's fine. How wide is a warehouse, tiles-wise?
4? 5? 5.
We've run out of space.
6.
So that's 5, 6. That's 6 potential unloaders. That's a lot of unloaders. Right?
Yeah. I think we probably don't need the space in the middle. I think we can pack them in like this.
Yeah.
Can we fit one more here, or did I miss? I feel like we should start from this side.
Yeah, probably.
We might want to load, unload two sides of the warehouse each. Maybe we are underestimating the scale here.
The potential scale.
Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, if a warehouse is full, it is going to take 1 bajillion years to relocate it. And if we decide we can't get stuff out of it fast enough, we're going to be very sad. Right?
So, what if we go... 3 spaces in between. No, you'd need even more than that, wouldn't you? You need 4 spaces in between.
So we could run 2 belts through?
Because then you get the 2 belts like that.
Can an underground belt reach under a warehouse? No. Red ones might, though.
Yeah.
The red ones have a further reach. But the problem with running 2 belts is we have to run 10 belts because we have 10 warehouses. Right?
This is for unloading. So for loading the warehouses, you just have the inputs, right? That can just meet flush against this side of the warehouse.
Right, but how do we get to this warehouse?
I was saying run them top to bottom. Like run them vertically. So instead of having them a horizontal line, have them a vertical line. Just like they are right there. And just straight down. So the next warehouse would be like... I can't place it because I don't have any landfill. It'd be on the middle of this water patch, basically.
Okay. Is there any way to use both dimensions? We would save a lot of space if we could solve both dimensions.
What do you mean?
If we could do a 2x5 rectangle, or a 4x4 rectangle with a corner missing, that feels more compact than a big long string of 10 warehouses. It probably doesn't matter because we have long string of 10 smelters. What if we put them up here instead of in this space that we just landfilled? What if we put one above each smelter? I mean, we'd have to move all the stuff I built, right? But if we put one above each smelter, move the smelting operations down maybe a warehouse length. So that the feed lines are still up there.
Okay.
And the warehouse just lives right here where it's smelting.
But you can't run the underground underneath it.
Okay. So the warehouse lives... How big are they? I mean, if we...
6x6.
Yeah. If we move...
Which is an even number.
Yeah, so let's build a mock-up. If we have a warehouse, and the warehouse, let me move it down so we have room for the mock-up. So the warehouse is going to load from the top and the right, just so we can use as much loading space as possible.
Okay.
And then it's going to unload from the left and the bottom.
Okay.
And then that needs to feed into the smelting.
Yeah.
So we make that's going to be one-sided. I wanted to T-junction these together. Somehow, cleverly. There we go. Right, and then... Yep. That just feeds... So the coal would come down... here?
Don't worry too much about the coal.
Right.
Because by the time we're using this, we'll have electric smelting.
And then the whole smelting operation just exists this far down. And does how smelting does. Right?
Okay.
Like that? So we're just installing one warehouse at the top of each smelting operation?
I'm just trying to work out, like, if it's better to have all the warehouses close to the train station, or whether it's to have them close to the smelting areas. And it's a purely aesthetic question. And has no gameplay mechanical difference.
I think it does.
I don't think it does.
Yeah.
Because either way, you're going to have belt running from the train station to the smelting area. Whether the warehouse is at the beginning or the end.
Right. But if the warehouse is close to smelting, then when there's less stuff sitting on belts doing nothing. Because the belts from the train station will get cleared out into the warehouse. And as soon as the stuff's moved out of the warehouse, it is immediately being smelted. Instead of traveling along a long belt and then sitting on the belt. I don't know how much that matters, but it is a thing.
I'm going to be completely honest. I don't understand the point you're conveying, but that's my problem because I'm not braining good. Yeah. Not your problem.
I mean, it's not a big difference. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But material sitting on belts is material that has we've spent time and energy and resources to mine out of the ground, and it's not doing anything. I guess, I mean, material sitting in a warehouse is exactly the same thing.
It's exactly the
same thing. But my gut feeling is that it's best to have the warehouse where it's being used rather than where it's being unloaded.
I my problem is that this design that you've sort of set up here, where you've got effectively 12 unloaders and 12 loaders, right? Yeah. To put things onto a single belt is probably not how the warehouse will eventually function.
Why?
It's much more likely that the warehouse will have will be outputting to two different belts.
Why? It's going to output ore to two different belts to feed two different smelters?
Yeah, potentially. Because we only want one warehouse per ore. Like, a warehouse stores... how many items is it? It's 800 stacks of 200. I'm no mathematician, but that's...
stores lots of stuff. Lots is an acceptable mathematical 000? Term, I think.
Lots? Okay.
Yeah.
I was going to use something slightly more vulgar. My Australianism was going to come out then, and I stopped myself. a lot. A truckload, Llama.
If this... Yeah, where truck might be a naughty word instead. So if this goes this way, and this feeds two smelting areas, is... Mm-hmm. Six arms dumping onto a belt enough to feed two smelting areas? I don't think it is.
I don't know.
I mean, maybe what we'll end up doing after we... You know what? We don't need to plan for 80 years in the future. Let's plan for now. This will work for now, and it will give us storage space so we can... empty all these mines, right?
Yeah, I think our main purpose right now is storage space, right?
Yeah.
Do we want to move our entire smelting area just for storage space? No, not really. I don't want to I don't want to have to shift the entire thing that we built the 4 hours we played yesterday down 8 tiles. But you can do that if you want. I would just set up 8 warehouses in a line.
Yeah, so are we leaving them enough space to load and unload from all of their available inserter arm area? Is that a thing we care about with this initial warehouse build? Or are these just temporary warehouses to make the mines get out of the way?
Let's just make them temporary warehouses to make the mines get out of the way.
Okay, then let's just do a big long row of 10 and load from the bottom and unload on the top or something.
Let's do this, Slama. Put a warehouse down here. Below each ore depository. And then smart inserter any excess ore off the ends of the belts. For each of the materials.
Okay, and you are prepared to move these warehouses later?
If they need to be moved, yeah.
Okay.
I'll do it. Can we even make smart inserters? We can't make smart inserters, can we? No.
I think so. We're really close. We're one tech off of smart inserters.
How do you make smart inserters in this game? What is the technology?
I am 100% certain we are one tech away.
We can make smart chests in one tech.
Well, it's in like electronics or something, right? Do we not have them? We have them. Yeah, we have smart inserters. They're on the road below the other inserters.
Oh, we do. We do. And they require basic electronic circuits.
Yep, which we need to set up. Those need to be not built in our inventory, solder. I think.
They require solder. And solder requires resin and solder plates. And solder plates requires tin plates and lead plates.
So what you're saying is no smart inserters for a while.
Well, I mean, we have tin, right? This is tin over here. This is tin. This is tin. This is tin, and this is lead. They're right next to each other, so we can make solder. We can make solder plate. It needs to be made in furnaces, so that's fun.
It needs to be made in the blue furnaces. So,
in the metal mixy furnaces.
I'm pretty sure. Yeah.
I'm gonna make ten metal mixy furnaces that are gonna make solder for us. Cause I have a feeling solder is a thing that we're going to use a lot of.
Do we wanna set it up a smelting area in this big smelting area? Or do we wanna set it up a production area above? Just for consistency and beautifulness. We could put it down here past the steel.
But then we have to route
Yes.
Solder the components.
Yes.
Down we can rip components down there. That's fine. We just need to
It has to have two in belts because we have to have coal and two metals. Which is gross. Maybe we make a few smart inserters in our pockets.
One row?
We can't smelt the solder. Or the resin.
Yeah, you can't actually make the plate. Or the resin. The resin's wood, right? We need to smelt raw wood.
Yeah.
No, we need to put raw wood goes into an automator. It just needs to go into an automator.
Oh, it gets made in a factory, not in a smelter.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's raw wood.
Yeah.
So,
the stuff that we stopped piping.
Yeah, so we want a line parallel to this. So we want to do this with the raw wood. Right? And then we just make some resin.
Sure. Yep. Yep. Absolutely.
And then we use long-handled inserters to put it out, which means I need more iron.
I can make the long-handed inserters. I'm making them now. Long-handed inserters is easy. So, as I'm making resin.
And then we run a resin line up to the bus. I am very concerned at how wide our 12 spaces across bus is happening. It is quickly approaching ridiculous.
So do we, like, twist in all of the lines now? Oh, you want to insert them out that side. Yeah, that's cool. I can do that.
Wait.
One, two, three. Okay, so that's resin. So do we want to twist all of these components in on themselves now?
I don't know. I don't have any idea what needs to be bussed and what doesn't. I just know that this is quickly getting very wide. I think we can do one more at this width. I kind of want to do it here.
So will an underground boy? No.
Nope, that's already too wide.
It kind of needs to come in.
Whoa! Now. Whoa, don't do that!
It sort of needs to come in here, Llama.
Where? Through the iron mine?
Because...
Yep.
Yeah, well, this is clear. This strip, it's being mined and is clear already.
Yep.
So... So that's going to be the easiest place to...
Why are you undergrounding it? It's already being mined, right? We can just run it right through the mine.
Yes. I don't know, my brain. I just want to clarify, chat. I warned Llama.
Yeah.
I warned him.
Yep. He did.
I was like, no, Llama, this is a bad idea. Let's do it anyway. He said, okay, it's his fault.
It is my fault.
Right. Hey, so do we... Oh, you moved the labs over here. I was like, why is our science just working?
Because I put the labs over here so that our science could just work.
Okay, so we're not going to pinch these belts at the moment. We're just going to run all of these up. I think because we have the space in between, we can utilize the space in between.
Yeah, right? like our... Where did our belt factory go? I had a factory making belts. Did I pick it up at the end of the cast yesterday?
Were you ashamed, Llama?
I might have moved it. I think I had to move it. It used to be right here. That's what this arm is doing. Okay. I had to move it to run the iron over to make steel.
Okay. All right.
So we should make a new belt thing. We should make green science right now because I think we're out of red science projects. Oh. Chemical processing 1 is a red science project.
Yeah.
But we should make
one,
like, a legitimate actual red and green science place and a legitimate actual science farm and make some progress. Yeah?
Yes, and we should make solder. I'm going to make solder. Because we're going to need solder for, like, lots of stuff.
Okay.
From what I've seen.
You should come occasionally and take some boards out of the circuit board box. So that when you're making stuff, you don't have to make circuit boards in your inventory because it takes a long time.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I am doing that.
Oh, there's a chest over on the left where I dumped my inventory before I went to fight the biters.
Okay. So, are we making the solder point on the actual... in the smelting area? Or do I want to just make a alloy smelting area in this? Because I can just... Yeah, no. I think we bust coal. Well, no. Eventually, we won't need to bust coal, right? Because eventually, coal will be irrelevant in the smelting process because we will be using electrics, right? I imagine eventually you can smelt alloys with electric furnace. There's got to be an electric alloy furnace, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I imagine. So, we can just... So I'm just going to make a... This is a temporary solution.
Okay.
Okay. And it may prove to be permanent.
Okay. It's not going to be wide enough to fit electrics double wide.
I'm just going to be feeding them in the one side.
Okay, so do you want coal running up along the other side there?
Yeah, I'm just going to have coal running up the other side.
That is a thing I can
temporarily.
Do. Yep. Oh, how many tiles? You want the coal to come... Why are you using long... Oh, you're using long outs.
Long output.
So you want coal right here?
Yes. Yes. Okay. And that will give us solder. Because it looks like solder is going to be really important. If Bob's Mods is a more accurate representation of making all of these different electrical components,
yep.
Then solder is going to be used everywhere. Air compressors, go. It's too much, Llama. Why am I using long... I've been making long-handed burner insert. I just made long-handed burner inserters.
Those are bad.
I am so dumb. I have 10 long-handed burner inserters. which are going to serve no purpose whatsoever. Okay. We're going to have a solder output.
Okay, your coal is coming in.
Excellent. Okay. I need more inserters.
Is solder... What do you call it, Dacon? Do you pronounce the L? Because both...
Solder.
Both Americans and Australians, apparently, pronounce it without the L.
The material is solder. The act of soldering something is actually soldering.
Really? We never pronounce the L.
Yeah. In Australia, yeah, it's... The material that you solder with, the material you solder with is solder, which is very strange.
Yeah.
At least that's sort of how I grew up with solder.
What was I doing? I was going to make a better circuit board factory. I think we're going to need these basic circuit boards. Get made into the better circuit boards, right?
Oh, Llama, you need to actually tell these furnaces what they're making.
Oh, because they have... Yeah, they can't just multiple. Pick from the inputs. They can't know.
Yep.
Okay, so I want to design a high output basic circuit board facility. Do we want to bus wood or boards?
What do you mean?
Well, our current bus is wood that's being made into boards for the boards.
Yeah.
Do we want to bus boards or wood? I don't know. I don't know which is correct.
I don't know.
Eventually we replace wood with synthetic wood made from oil, I think. People have been saying.
No. 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 Llama.
What? Why do I have a resin in my inventory? What? How did I get that? Oh, you can make those. What? What? No,
what
no, no.
What are the two metals? What are the two metals on my split line?
Glass and... lead?
And what's soda made out of?
Not glass. Your tin's over there to the left. Yeah.
Can you reroute my coal, please?
You just want it in the next one over? Are you moving the whole shindig?
I'm going to have to.
Okay. Do 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 do.
This was a terrible idea.
Well, the only thing that was terrible about the idea, or do you mean the idea of playing with half a brain?
The idea of playing normal Factorio, I could probably get away with it right now because I have experienced the game and am familiar with everything.
But Bob's all the new stuff and not recognizing the difference between glass so and tin because they're basically the same color. Bob's mod is not colorblind friendly, that's for sure.
No, no, you do not want to be colorblind. And
I guess, I mean, they're shades of gray, which maybe it is colorblind okay. Maybe it's fine. It's just not low perception check friendly.
You haven't slept for 23 hours. You have a negative 4 to your wisdom. I need this to come over here. Hey, you rerouted my coal already.
Yeah.
You're a champion.
Lama. You are welcome, sir. Please enjoy your happy, happy coal times. I like this bus. No, I don't. There's nothing to like about it. I'm trying to decide if I like it, and I think the answer is no. Okay, I'm going to make a circuit board place. Hi, Joe.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Llama.
What?
I would like my pass on kindergarten maths now, please.
Okay. Congratulations. You have counted to a number.
Yay, arithmetic. Okay. Definitely 100% doing this the first time. Definitely planned it perfectly. Definitely didn't stuff it up.
Are you ready for junior high math? Because it's time for circuit board ratios.
But they're all different, Llama.
I know
the old ones.
So the circuit boards take 1 second now instead of half a second, which is a big deal. Hi, Cygnus. So, research. Armor crafting 2, go. So I need 3 copper cable per second and 1 wood board per second. I get 2 wood boards per half second. I get 4 per second out of 1 facility. So one of those will support 4 basic circuit boards. 1 board maker, 4 basic circuit boards. And then the cable gets also made at 4 per second, I think. Yep. So if that's going at 4 per second, I need 3 cable facilities to feed these 4. Other things.
You know the weird thing is, Llama, with this initial smelting area set up, got, if we wanted to, we could totally chain bust this.
Do we want to
move
do
this free space?
The problem for me is I don't know which things to bus. Is so tin makes solder. Does it do anything besides get alloyed with stuff? Tin also makes bronze, probably. Is that a thing? Yeah.
Yeah, tin would definitely also make bronze.
So do we bus solder and bronze, or do we bus tin? Like, there's too much. I don't know which things we need to bus.
See this, the smelting area that I've set up for the solder, which we now have, right? This is all solder on this belt.
Uh-huh.
If we had considered like alloys before laying our initial furnaces, we could have had the tin in between the copper and the lead to have, you know, solder here.
Yeah,
and
we can still do that. We can swap the lanes.
Do you want to move the copper over to where the stone is then?
And put the stone. I want to move the glass. The thing is, I want the copper. I want to put the tin where the glass is. Which means the thing you just moved would need to get moved back. But I want the copper next to the iron.
Yeah, you do. You want copper near iron. I am not sure. Hey, we have solder.
Okay.
We have solder.
So, if I am a clever girl, we can have... it's not even. I wonder if it matters.
Two. But not really.
Yeah. So the thing is, I need to put three wires in each factory, but the wires get made faster than the boards, so the arms can do two cycles. So maybe they only need one?
It would. I normally I would be thrilled to provide my input.
But today is not normal.
By the way, I just made a bazillion tea solder. We need carbon for basic electronic components.
Carbon? How do you make carbon?
Carbon is made with coal and water in a something that doesn't look like a normal something.
Ooh, a red smeltery. That's fun.
A chemical furnace.
Yeah. Belts.
Hey, we have coal down here, right? Coal. I'm going to start making carbon.
Okay.
As well, because all of these intermediate products that we're going to require. I was just looking at the basic electronic circuit boards.
Uh-huh.
The basic electronic boards, which are the upgrade of the basic circuit board, require basic electronic components, which require tinned copper wire.
Okay.
And carbon. And solder. Which requires solder plate and resin, which requires...
Yep. Maybe I wasn't ready. Maybe my body was not ready for more Factoria. I thought it was.
Of course, your buddy. Of course, your brain is ready.
It's time to plug this thing in and see if it runs at capacity.
What are you plugging in?
The boardifier. The circuit boarder.
The circuit boarder.
Yep.
So, how do I... But I need...
the sounds of Factorio. But how do I... What? No! But...
I changed my mind. These are not going here. I need water. I need water for the chemical food. It just doesn't even... It. How's your circuit board going?
The wire factories are not running at capacity, which I want them to be.
Okay.
The problem is that 3-4 doesn't fit as cleverly as 2-3 did in the previous incarnation of circuit boards. So this factory is having downtime waiting for circuits? And these are having downtime waiting to be unloaded?
Pipes.
Can one? One would like to. One being me. Can one put... No. What I wanted to do is put some wires from one wire factory into the other wire factory so okay. that they could be taken out of there. How? Okay. Well, this is going to make us some boards for a while. And it's fine. But I would like to make it perfect. Duh! Wait, no. Yes? Is this right? It doesn't feel right. The middle two factories are being fed differently than the top and bottom one. But maybe we're running at capacity now. Why have you stopped? You don't have any boards. Why don't you have any boards? This thing should be giving you plenty of boards. Can it not unload fast enough? Aha.
Have you discovered the problem?
Well, I've discovered a problem. And when I solve it, it will help me to diagnose the next problem. It's kind of how I play this game. I need to fix the thing that I know is broken so I can see if other stuff are broken.
I need more power poles. More power poles.
We're still not unloading this fast enough. Do we have fast inserters? No, like basic electronic circuit boards, you're the worst. So much yellow arms. Okay. Now we're unloading this as fast as it can build plates. Something is slowing down the boards because they are not eating up all of this wood, and they should be. Ooh, more science. What can we do for red? Shotgun shell shooting speed. Neat.
We are now making carbon.
Yeah, so the ratio of wires to boards is 3-4. Wait, did I do... These each make 2 wires per second. So I'm getting 6 wires per second. No, these each make 4 wires per second. So I'm getting 12. And these should be using 12. But I'm guessing that the top and bottom one aren't working properly. Let's watch it. Yeah, this one isn't getting enough wire. It's having short delays while it waits for wire. The problem is I can't tell these to prioritize this feeding this. Maybe if I make this a fast arm or put 2, they can do their priorities correctly. That unpowers arms.
I hold in my hands the building blocks of life.
This is working now. Just needed more arms.
Okay. Tinned copper wire requires copper cable and tin plates. 3 copper cables per tin plate. Copper cable takes 0.5 to make. You get 2 out of 1 plate, which means that if I have... 3 doing it, I get 6 plates, 6 copper wire at a time every 0.5 seconds, so 6 every 0.5.
Are the wires factories being loaded fast enough? Yeah.
6 every 0.5 means I need 2 tin plates. 2 tin and copper.
So if I eat all these boards, this should run at exactly the speed it's getting boards. Yeah. Okay, we're making basic circuit boards like a boss.
So, the next recipe I need to work on to get the next tier of circuit board, the basic electronic board, requires me to make basic electronic components which requires me to have tinned copper wire, which requires tin and copper. The more I think about it, it would appear that it should go iron, copper, tin, lead.
Yep, so we want to swap tin and glass stone. And move your solder operation. We don't have to move your solder operation. We can just ship tin over there.
I guess we can just...
Where's the inefficiency?
This
thing isn't... It's almost running perfectly. But something is running a little too slow. My guess is it's this middle one. This one seems to be going full bore.
It's probably just input-output lag because of low insert.
The bottom one is barely getting enough wire. And it might have...